गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू, वेलकम टू द थर्ड लेक्चर ऑफ हेलो एल्किन्स एंड हेलो एरिन्स. माई सेल्फ सुमन सिंह. सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द जेमिनल डायलाइट एंड विसिनल डायलाइट एंड टर्मिनल डायलाइट. ओके, सो नाउ बेस्ड ऑन द नेचर ऑफ कार्बन एटम वी विल लर्न अबाउट, बेस्ड ऑन द नेचर ऑफ कार्बन एटम देयर इज द विनाइल हैलाइड, एलाइल हैलाइड, एराइल हैलाइड और बेंजाइल हैलाइड. वी विल सी दैट. That notes you will get in the PDF. Here I will show you what is vinyl halide. After that we will see that nomenclature. Okay, so whenever we are talking about the vinyl halide, so when we are talking about vinyl halide, okay, VINYLHALIDES, vinyl halide. Okay, when we are talking about the vinyl halide, one thing we should keep in mind that suppose which one we will call as vinyl halide. Suppose this is our carbon, okay, and from through this carbon, if suppose this halogen is attached here, okay, and then to become a vinyl halide it should be sp2. I hope you know about the hybridization which I have discussed in first lecture. This carbon should be sp2. And one more criteria is non-aromatic. Okay, non-aromatic. Okay, so this type of halide in which the carbon to which the halogen is attached is sp2 and non-aromatic, then that type of halide is called vinyl halide. We can take one example here. You can take one example just like this. This is the example of vinyl halide in which suppose here chlorine is attached here. So this carbon is what? This carbon is sp2. Okay, and one more thing, this vinyl halide will not show substitution reaction. Okay, it will not give substitution reaction. I hope you have heard, you have understood what is vinyl halide. Now next, when we are talking about aryl halide, so aryl halide is what? Allyl halide, sorry, ALLYL. Okay, allyl halide. Allyl halide. So allyl halide is what? You can see, simply you can understand what is allyl halide. So one more thing, this allyl halide, it goes substitution reaction very fast. Always keep in mind that allyl halide will give substitution reaction very fast, just like SN1 and SN2. We will learn afterward what is SN1 and SN2. So it will give substitution reaction very fast. And which type of compound is called allyl halide? We will see that. Now suppose this is a carbon and one more carbon is here, and through this carbon one halide is attached. Okay, so always keep in mind this carbon should be sp3. Okay, and this carbon should be sp2 and plus vicinal. Okay, so this type of halide in which the first carbon through which the halogen is attached is sp3, and this one back to that carbon is sp2, then that type of halide is called allyl halide. Okay, you can take the example here. So example, so many examples are there. One example I will give you, just like CH2, double bond CH, again CH2 Cl. okay, this is the example of 1 degree allyl halide. Okay, suppose because this carbon through which it is attached, chlorine is attached, this chlorine is attached to this carbon, so because this carbon is 1 degree, okay, that is why it is called primary allyl halide or 1 degree allyl halide. If this carbon is 2 degree, then this will be 2 degree allyl halide. If this carbon is attached to 3 other carbon, just like this, you can take the example here, just like this. If this carbon is there, and through this carbon, one CH3 is here, one CH3 is here, and one Cl is here. Okay, and suppose there is CH, and this one is double bond CH2. So you can see here, through this carbon is 3 other carbon is attached. one is this, and one is this. So this is 3-degree carbon. So this is called what? 3-degree allyl halide or tertiary allyl halide. So I hope you have understood what is vinyl halide and allyl halide. Now we will talk about allyl halide. ARYL. Okay, we will talk about allyl halide. ARYL, allyl halide. So which one is called allyl halide? So you can take simple example. Suppose this is a carbon, and through this carbon one halogen is attached. Okay, so what is the main criteria to become an allyl halide? This should be sp2. Okay, this carbon should be sp2 as well as what? Aromatic. aromatic. Okay, if this carbon is aromatic, sp2 and aromatic, and through this carbon if this halogen is attached, then this type of compound is called what? Aryl halide or aromatic halide. Okay, so there are so many examples. You can take one example here, just like this. You can take the example, this is a benzene ring here, and through this benzene ring one more benzene ring is attached here, and here suppose Cl. So what is the name of this compound? This compound name will be alpha chloro methylene. Okay, alpha chloro methylene. Okay, I hope you have understood this. So one more thing, also always keep in mind that aryl halide does not favor substitution reaction. Okay, I hope you are understanding. Vinyl halide will not give will not give substitution reaction, but allyl halide will give substitution reaction very fast. When we are talking about aryl halide will also does not favor substitution reaction. So this was about your aryl halide. Now when we are talking about this benzyl halide, so from the name you can understand benzyl halide is what. So when we are talking about benzyl halide, so benzyl halide, suppose this is one carbon, and this one is one more carbon, and this from this carbon one halogen is attached here. So this carbon should be aromatic. Okay, aromatic, aromatic. This carbon should be as aromatic, and this carbon should be sp3. Okay, then that type of compound is called benzyl halide. Okay, benzyl, okay, benzyl halide. So I hope all of you have understood this. So benzyl halide, when we are talking about benzyl halide, I will give you one example. Okay, so example is like this. Suppose this is one benzene ring here, and through this benzene ring CH2Cl. okay, and suppose this is another benzene ring, and through this one CH is attached here, and one chlorine is here, and another chlorine is here, and one more benzene ring, and through this benzene ring one carbon is attached here, and one chlorine here, and one chlorine is here. Okay, 3-chlorine. So this one will be benzyl chloride. Okay, or chlorophenylmethane, when we are talking about the IUPAC name. And this one will be benzyl halide. Okay, benzyl, and this one will be benzo. How you will identify? If 3, you can see here 3 halogen is attached here, means it will be benzo. Okay, if 2 halogen, you can see here 2 halogen is there, it means benzyl, benzyl. If 1 will be benzyl, benzyl. Okay, so this was all about benzyl halide. I hope all of you have understood this, and this in the PDF note it will be there, don't worry about that. Now we will see about the nomenclature. Okay, so when we are talking about the nomenclature, you can see here in nomenclature it is already written here. Suppose this is an alkene, and in this alkene you have this alkene part is called suffix. Okay, and the halogen part will be added in prefix. I hope you know about the suffix and prefix. So suppose we have this compound. You can see here this compound. When we are talking about this compound, so numbering, how will we give the number? If we are giving numbering from here 1 2 3 4 5 6, then it will be wrong. You can see here this is wrong method, the one which is written in white color. And if you are talking about giving here 1 2 3 4 5 6, so this is the correct method. So how we will name, we will name alphabetically. So in methyl and chloro, which one will come first? Chloro will come first. So in which position chloro is there? In third position chloro is there. So what we will write? 3 chloro. After that methyl will be in the which position? Which is second position. So it will be 2 methyl. How many carbon is there? 6. So mean hexane. I hope you have understood this hexane. Okay, now next, when we are talking about the next, so we have some of the compound is given here. You can see some of the compound is given here. Some of the compound is given here. CH3, CH2CH, CH2Cl. So what is the name of this compound? When you are asked to name this compound, this one, A, number A. So to number A, what we can name to this compound? Number A. Can we write like this? Number A. Can we write like this? Like this? You can write for number A, okay? We can write like this. Here chlorine is attached. So how we will name? We will give name to 1, 2 and 3. Right? So what will be the name? 1 chloro. Okay, 1 chloro in second position. You see in the second position there is methyl group is attached, so it will be 2 methyl. How many carbon? 1 2 3 carbon means propane. I hope you have understood this. Now next, when we are talking about this number B, CH3 three times CHBr. Okay, so how we can elaborate this? You can write like this, right? You can write like this. So what will be the name of this? In the second position, we will name like this, 1, 2 and 3. In the second position, it is bromine, means 2 bromo. Now, 2 bromo. After that, in the second position, you can see methyl group is also attached here. So it will be 2 methyl, 2 bromo, 2 methyl. How many carbon? 1, 2, 3 carbon means propane. Okay. So I hope you have understood this. Now, we will see number 3. So when we are talking about the number 3, how we will name? So if you will give the numbering like this, 1 2 3, okay, so it will become wrong, okay, because only 3, we have to as you know, you have learned in class 11, we have to select the longest chain. Okay, so when we are when we have to select the longest chain, what we will give? 1 2 3 and 4. Okay, so you can see the in first position, which is chloro. So what we can write for this, what we can write? 1 chloro, 2 in the second position, methyl is there. You can see methyl is there in the second position. 2 methyl, okay, 1 chloro, 2 methyl. How many carbon? 4 carbon means butane. I hope you have understood this. 1 chloro, 2 methyl, butane. Now next, when we are talking about this, so how we will name? We will name like this. Numbering should be from here 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, so in first place you can see fluorine is in the which position? It is in the fourth position. So how we will write this? 4 fluoro, 1 1. How many methyl group is there? You can see 2 methyl group, right? So it will be 1 1. I have a 4 fluoro, 1 1 dimethyl. How many carbon? 6 carbon. And cyclic ring is there, so what we can write? Cyclohexane. I hope you have understood this. 4 fluoro, 1 1 dimethyl, cyclohexane. Okay, now next, number E. So when we are talking about number E, you see here how we will name this. So numbering will be from this side, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So in the fourth position it is bromine, in the third position there is a methyl. Okay, so how we will write? We will write with the alphabetic order. 4, in the fourth position it is bromo, means 4 bromo. Okay, in the third position it is methyl. You will write 3 methyl. How many carbon? You see 7 carbon means hept, and single bond everywhere, heptane. Okay, I hope you have understood this E number. Now this one, for naming this, what we can write? Numbering will be 1 2, 3 and 4. So in the first position there is bromo, and in the second position there is a chloro. So for this type of compound, since you can see that is the dash one is given, and the one you can see this, no, this one, this black one and this dotted one. So in this type of naming we have to do RS naming. RS naming I hope you have learned in class 11 in organic chemistry. So it will be S, okay? So it will be S, and in the place, in which position? In the first position bromo is there, S, 1 bromo, S, 2 chloro cyclobutane, okay? So this was S, 1 bromo, S, 2 chloro cyclobutane. So this was all about some of the naming. Now next, we will see next slide. We have to give the IUPAC name of this. So this one, I think all of you have, all of you know about this structure. This is the structure of DDT, right? The structure of DDT. Okay. So you can see here. The naming, numbering will be, this one will be first carbon and second carbon. How we will name this? We will name this like this. 1, 1, 1. How many chlorine? 1, 2, 3 chlorine, right? So 1, 1, trichloro. Okay, now in the second position you see here, in the second position I hope you have learned, if now in the second position it is UCNC, one this and this one. So how we will run, how we will write, 1, 1, 1 trichloro, this one is 3 chloro, 1, 2, 3 trichloro, okay, 2, 2, 2, 2 bis, because 2 is there, 1, 2, 2, 2 means what we write, bis, right? You have learned this in class 11, bis. In base, what we have to write? 4 chloro, 1, 2, 3, 4. In which position chlorine is there? You can see 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth position, 4 chloro. In here also, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4 position. Here also 4. So base, 4 chloro, phenyl ethane. Okay, 4 chloro, phenyl ethane. So, here what we can write this 1, 1 trichloro, 2, 2 base, 4 chloro, phenyl ethane. Okay, so this was the naming of DDT. I hope you have got this. Now next, you have to give the IUPAC name of this. So how we will name this? It is very easy, I hope you all can do. So this one will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what will be the name here? In the second position it is bromo, means 2 bromo, right? In the third in the first position it is chloro, 1 chloro, because B used to come first after the C. So we will write first 2 bromo, 1 chloro. And in the third position you see here iodo is there, okay? So 1 bromo, 2 chloro, 3 iodo. How many carbon? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 means pent. Pentane is there, but cyclic ring is there. So what we will write? 2 bromo, 1 chloro, 3 iodo, cyclopentane. I hope you have got this. Now next, this one. So to name this, what we can write? So naming this, so we will give the numbering like this. Wait, we'll give the numbering like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In the fifth position it is fluoro, so what we can write? 5 fluoro. How many carbon? 5 carbon means pent. In one position there is double bond, means 1 ene. I hope you have got this. Let me write this, 5 fluoro, fluoro, okay, pent 1 ene. Okay, so this is the name of this compound. I hope you have understood this. So this was one more, it is given here. Now this is very complicated. You can see the structure is very complicated here. So but we will name this. How we will name this? We will give the numbering. What will be the numbering here? How we will give the number? So we will number like this, 1, 2, and 3. So now you see, in first and third position there is 1, 1 chlorine, so it is no need to worry about this. You just write 1, 1, 1, 3 dichloro, okay, 1, 1, 3 dichloro. You can see first position, in the third position there is a chlorine, so no need to think anything about this. Just you write as it is, 1 chloro and 1, 1, 3 dichloro. After that you see in the second position, here is also chlorine and here is also chlorine. So what we will write? 2-2. Okay, bis. I hope you have right. Bis, tetra case and all you know. Na? So bis, chloromethyl. How many carbon? 3 carbon means propane. I hope you have understood this. 1-1, 1-3 dichloro, 2-2 bis chloro methyl propane. I hope all of you have understood this. Now next, for this I will giving you an homework. You do okay, you leave it. We will discuss this in the next class. So keep up to this. Now let me discuss about the isomerism also today. After that we will see, time is there. So now when we are talking about the isomers of haloalkanes, always keep in mind that it will give only, basically it will give two type of isomer, which is chain isomer and positional in structural structural isomer and stereo isomer. You know, no, two type of isomer is there, structural and isomer and stereo. In structural isomer it will give two type, one will be chain and another will be positional. Okay, functional, when we are talking about the functional, it will not give functional. Always remember that it will not give metamers and tautomerism. It will not give. But ring, whenever we are talking about the ring chain, it will give. So basically you have to remember three things: chain isomer, position isomer and ring chain. Okay, these three. And stereo, when we are talking about the stereo, it will give optical, it will give geometrical isomerism and conformational. Okay, these three. So now we will see this. We will see the example, okay, of chain isomer and position isomer. So when we are talking about the chain isomer and position isomer, we can easily give the example of chain isomer. So when we are taking the example of chain isomer, this is what? One here chlorine, suppose. Okay, and one is this. Here it is chlorine. So these two are what? These two are chain isomer of each other. What will be the name? Can you name this? One is, this one is what? Chlorobutane. And this one is what? 1-chloro-2-methyl. We can name like this, no? 1, 2 and 3. So 1 chloro, in the first position chloro is there. In the second position methyl group is attached, and 3 here. So what, and this will be the name, what will be the name of this? 1-chloro-2-methylpropane and here chlorobutane. So these two are the chain isomer of each other. Now we will see position isomer. When we are talking about the position isomer, suppose this is our chlorine here, and in one place this one is here, chlorine is attached. So what will be the name of this? 1-chloro-butane, right? And this one, let me name this 1, 2, 3 and 4. So what will be the name of this? 2-chloro, right? In the second position you can see chlorine is there. 2-chloro, how many carbon? 4 carbon, means but, and single bond is there, so butane. I hope all of you have understood this. So these two are what? These two are the example of what? Positional isomer. Now next we will talk about the ring chain. So when we are talking about the ring chain, you can take one example for ring chain also, like this. If you are taking one example, 1-chlorine is here and 1-chlorine is here, and this one. So this is the example of ring chain. So one, what is the name of this? This one is chlorobutene, ENE, okay? And this one is what? 1-chloro, 1, 2, 3 and 4. If you are giving this number 1, this one is 2 and this one is 3 and this one is 4. So what will be the name? 1-chloro-cyclo, how many carbon? 4, means cyclobutane. So this is the example of ring chain, okay? Now when we come in the stereo isomer, so whenever we are talking about the stereo isomer, it will in stereo isomer we will see optical isomer. So when we are talking about the optical isomer, I have told you RS naming, I think you know about the RS naming. So we will take one example for optical, this, okay? So what will be the example? Suppose here it is 1-chlorine and here is hydrogen and here is C2H5, okay, H5, and this one is CS3. So this is what? S. This is S, okay? And this one is this one is what? Suppose this is H here, chlorine is here, and CH3 is here, and C2H5 is here. So this is what? R. So I hope you know how to identify S and R. So we have, for identifying S and R, we have to see the position. Suppose if it is clockwise, you know, no? Clockwise means R, and anti-clockwise means S. If the positions, whatever the, this one, if you will see this one will give the priority to this 1, 2, 3 like this. If it is 1, 2, 3, if it is coming like this, then it will be S. If it is coming like this, then it will be R. So this is the optical isomer, example of optical isomer. If you are not understanding this, please go and see the class 11 stereoisomer. In some basic concept of organic chemistry, it is there, stereoisomer. You just go through that, you will get idea. If you then also, if you will not understand, then you can you can message me. I will make a separate lecture on that optical isomers or stereoisomers. Okay, so now next is geometrical isomer. So geometrical isomer, you see, you know, na, cis and trans, you know, na. So suppose this is C double bond, carbon-carbon double bond, here it is chlorine, and here it is hydrogen, and here it is, wait, let me draw smaller one. Suppose it is chlorine here, suppose this is a chlorine double bond, chlorine here, carbon here, this one is chlorine, this one is hydrogen, and this one is H, and this one is Cl, okay. So this is what, you see both chlorine are on the same side, means it is cis, right? You know, na? And if you take the example of this chlorine double bond, here it is chlorine, here it is hydrogen, and here it is again chlorine, and here it is hydrogen. So this is what? Trans. Okay, I hope you have understood this. So this is the example of geometrical isomer. Now conformational. For conformational, you know, na? Conformational one is okay, in conformational is not so important. Okay, we will see one example of conformational also. Okay, we will see here. One is hydrogen is here, one hydrogen is here, and this one is Cl. Here hydrogen, here also hydrogen, and here it is Cl. Okay, opposite side. Now again, in this example, we will see here H, here H, here H, and here H, here Cl, same side. So this is an example of conformational. Okay. So this was all about the conformational isomerism, and now next we will see reactivity and selectivity principle. So reactivity, when we are talking about the reactivity and selectivity principle, one thing always keep in mind that reactivity and selectivity. Selectivity means what? Selection of position to attack. As you can see, I have written, it has been written here. Selectivity is what? Selection of position to attack. And always remember that selectivity is inversely proportional to reactivity. Okay. And when we are talking about the selectivity and reactivity, fluorine and iodine. When we are talking about the fluorine, the rate is too high that the selectivity principle will not be applicable here. Okay. Because its reaction is rate is tending to infinity, so it reaction is so fast, so selectivity principle will not work here. Okay, after that, when we are talking about iodine also selectivity principle will not work, because this rate is tending to zero, means very slow reaction, it will give very slow reaction. If it will work if we are adding here some oxides or anything, if you are adding, then only it will react, otherwise it will not react. So selectivity principle, in selectivity principle, these two has been cancelled out. Okay, so what we have to see? We have to see only chlorine and bromine. In chlorine and bromine also, always keep in mind that bromine is more selective than chlorine. Okay, bromine is more selective than chlorine. So one chart is there, selectivity table is there. You can see that, what does it means? You can see the carbon hydrogen bond is there, and one is chlorine here and bromine here. Okay, so it is 1 degree. If carbon hydrogen bond is 1 degree, or if it is 2 degree or 3 degree, how will be the reaction? If, what does it mean? Here it is, if carbon hydrogen bond is 1 degree, then it is written 1. If carbon hydrogen bond is 2 degree, it is written 3.8. Okay, 3.8, it is not 30.